from the crypt.
Hello. How are you? I'm Fearest Gup. Hi. Care for a chocolate? You sure? Mummy always said life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Sometimes you get a fudge scream. Sometimes you get new guts. Know what else Mummy said? She said, scary is as scary does. Which brings to mind the man in tonight's terror tale. He's just dying to get out of the mess he's in. Literally. It's a little piece of horrid candy I call... You Murderer.
They say, when you die, that you're supposed to see this intense white light. You're supposed to walk into it like it was the gates of heaven or something. At least that's the way I always heard it. Well, I'm dead. And so far, I've seen a lot of things. But some cockamamie white light ain't one of them. That's right, I'm dead. And one thing I can definitely tell you about it, it ain't like I expected it to be. Stick around, you might learn a thing or two. Just a couple of hours ago, I was alive as the rest of you. And then, seemed like destiny had taken a hand.
Seems that destiny has taken a hand.
What was that, Mr. Spinelli?
It's destiny that today of all days, you, doll, have come up with a campaign that's gonna save this company.
What was that slogan again?
Here's looking at you, kid.
I like it, Erica. It's got a familiar ring to it.
Thanks, Mr. Spinelli. Now, the way the campaign will work is this. Let me just make sure everything's...
Thanks, clear. Jimmy.
Okay. The first billboard will say, here's looking at you, kid, spelled E-W-E. Then...
That's pretty good, baby.
Here's looking at you, kid. You know, kid, go.
Sure, that's swell, Erica.
Okay, and the third one... Hair's looking at you, kid.
That's good. Very good. I like it. Jeez, is that the time?
It's 9:30.
Mr. Spinelli, call for you on 3. It was hard to hear, but I think they said it was Oscar.
Oscar, huh? Mm-hmm. That's strange. Excuse me, everybody. I'll be right with you. Oscar?
No, Lou. It's Betty. Surprised to hear my voice. I'm supposed to be dead, aren't I? Aren't I, Lou? Your pal, Oscar, sent a couple of goons over here to kill me. But I got bad news for you.
I hear what you're
saying. It didn't work. You hear me, Lou?
Listen. This won't do any good. You'll never understand me, but I'll try once, then give it up.
Don't bother, Lou. I'm calling the police. You're going to jail. Do you hear me, Lou? To jail.
Lou, are you okay? Lou?
Yeah, everything's all right, Erica. Just a little emergency at home, that's all.
Mr. Spinelli.
Yeah, everything's okay.
Mr. Spinelli, are you all right?
Everything's fine, Erica. In a part of town where I grew up, you did what you had to do to survive, whether it was legal or not. I robbed, cheated, even killed. I did a lot of hard time before I got wise to what a sucker's game it was. Unfortunately, no one was offering second chances. So I busted out of the joint, got a new name and a new face, and put my past behind me. At least I thought I did.
She knows?
Yeah, she knows.
What makes you so sure?
Somebody sent her those pictures in the mail. She knows all about me. Who I was, what I've done, the whole rap sheet. And there's only one other person in the world who knows the words to that song.
Is that a joke? You think that I'm the one that performed plastic surgery on you. I'm the guy that changed your face.
Yeah, and made me look like Bogart.
You know how hard that was? It would have been easier to make you look like Gabby Hayes. How could you think it was me? You're still a wanted man. Every police department in the country wants to get its hands on you. And I'm your accomplice. If you go down, I go down. Why would I spill my guts to anyone, let alone your wife?
Keep your pants on, Oscar. Now, look, I may have been a little too hasty. Okay, you're the doctor. What do we do?
If she's wise to us, there's only one thing we can do. Kill her.
Kill her? Don't be screwy.
I know a few guys. Might cost a little money, but they'll take care of it.
You're starting to scare me, Oscar.
And they'll make it look like a break-in or an accident. An unfortunate mishap while you were at the office.
You're talking crazy.
Don't go soft on me, Lou. We did it for each other then. We do it for each other now.
I know that.
Look, I'm not in love with the idea.
I know that, too.
But what's our alternative, Lou? The electric chair?
I wish you hadn't said that. That Oscar, he sure had a way with words. He was almost as good with them as he was with a scalpel. He always was the smart one. That's why he stayed in school, got off the streets, and never went to the big house. The big house. There was one thing I promised myself the last time I was inside. I ain't never going back.